nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Born and born.
Thank you very much, Lord. I have a sad note, a piece of news to pass along to you all, and that is that Marie Niebuhr passed away this weekend from cancer. She's been a very special person to us, as you know, many of you know her. She's been important to the origins of the North Grove Tea Party, and been a good friend of Barb and John, of course. She's been on the planning committee, the committee of correspondence with Ted, and certainly a dedicated patriot who understood deeply the meaning of our history and how it relates to us today. So I'd like to have us all think about Marie for a moment of silence, if you please. Thank you very much. Tonight's program is co-sponsored by the North Grove Tea Party, but also the Massachusetts Campaign for Liberty. Fred, stand up, say hello. Are there any first-timers here tonight? I'm here for more. Terrific. Thanks very much for coming. I think you'll find it worthwhile. May I ask how you heard about tonight? Was it through email? Radio? Anybody? Radio?
WCRN.
Yeah, okay, that's interesting. Word of mouth, some neighbors,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay, so if you'd like to be on our mailing list and are not, please see Barb O'Mara at the back when you get a chance. The way we're going to run it is as usual, and that is we're going to hold our questions until the end. And of course, being Flag Day, we're all going to mind the decorum of a nice, friendly conversation and meeting. Didn't even mention that, I know. There are some announcements. Barb O'Mara, do you have an announcement?
Sign the Anti-Common Core petition, and there are two very capable gentlemen back there who will probably find the right sheet for the right town, and if you would sign it, if you're not sure if you signed it, sign it again because your name will be eliminated, of course, if you have, so please do, we've got a week left, we've got 11,000 signatures that we have to get by the end of this week, so.
That was the one we've been signing all along.
Yes. Against Tom
Dick.
Right.
Dick.
Vegas.
And of course, right behind Barb, John.
Two very quick announcements. We just got some very good news that there are three scholarships available for youngsters to attend the Constitution Camp this summer. It's July the 10th and 17th. All expenses paid. So if you are interested, you've got children or grandchildren who might benefit by this experience. And I can tell you, it is a good experience. Two of our guys went there. So we're going to have a networking session afterwards. If you're interested, touch base with me. The other announcement is for those of you folks who are Trump supporters, there's an organization called the Massachusetts Coalition to Elect Trump that is underway. If you want to hear more about that, if you're interested in supporting that effort, again, see me at the end of the program.
Good. Now, we're also fortunate tonight to have us the star of Fox News, and that is the lady who's the Director of Policy Studies at the Center for Immigration Studies, and has been so for a while, right? Let's welcome Jessica Wong. She has
Hello, good evening. Thank you for coming. So glad to see so many of you
again, and welcome to folks who have been here before. I spent a little bit of time on your agenda tonight to talk to you about something very urgent, some urgent action that is needed. Many of you are familiar with perennial efforts by advocacy groups for illegal aliens to get the legislature to enact a provision in our law that would allow illegal aliens to obtain driver's license in the common law, which is not currently the case. Thanks in large part to the activism of some of you folks in this room, that measure has never succeeded. But they found a new tactic. Some of you may have heard about the fact that our licenses here in Massachusetts are not quite up to federal standards and are not acceptable as a form of identification to get into certain areas of federal buildings. And if they are not upgraded in certain ways, they will be not usable to board an airplane or to enter a federal building or in certain other scenarios. So Governor Baker would like to bring our license into federal standards and proposed legislation this year that would do that. It was not taken up by the legislature. As in that time-honored way of legislating, they found a must-pass bill, which is our budget bill, and in the House of Representatives, Brad Jones introduced the governor's proposal to upgrade the Massachusetts license. And it says it creates a two-tiered system of driver's licenses, one that is fully real ID compliant and another one that is not, but it says clearly that no Massachusetts licenses of either kind may be issued to someone who is not legally in the country. In addition, it provides a further security upgrade by saying that if a license is issued to someone who is here on a temporary visa, like a foreign student or a guest worker, they may get a license, but it will expire when their visa expires. We currently don't have that provision, and it's a loophole. So it's a good proposal. It was passed as an amendment to the budget bill in the House. When it got to the Senate, Bruce Tarr, the top Republican in the Senate, introduced the exact same thing, but a senator by the name of Tom McGee from Lynn, who is the chair of the Joint Transportation Committee that has been perennially considering giving driver's licenses to illegal aliens, said, "Well, I have a substitute amendment," and his proposal, or his amendment, says that we'll go with a two-tier system, but we are going to let illegal aliens get the Massachusetts driver's license. And that passed by a vote of 25-13 in the Senate, which means that all the Senate Republicans voted against it and 7 Democrats voted against it as well. I mean, it's a bad idea, but it passed. And so now, 6 members of the legislature are part of a conference committee that is reconciling the 2 different versions of the budget that passed. There's one in the House and there's one in the Senate. And so what we need to do is let the legislators know that, first of all, we know that this happened because it hasn't been widely covered in the media. I know only the State House News Service and the Boston Broadside covered it. And only the Boston Broadside really realized what the implications were of the 2 different versions of this. And so people don't know about it, and that's when bad things happen on Beacon Hill, is when legislators think that voters don't know what they're doing. So what we're trying to do is first educate people like yourselves who are activists who will be willing to take steps to make their views known to these lawmakers who are considering these 2 versions of the budget, and asking you to do 2 things. One is make a set of phone calls to the 6 members of the House and Senate who are deciding which version of the budget will be passed, and ask them to enact the House version of the Real ID amendment to the budget, and tell them why. Tell them Senate version allows licenses to be issued to illegal aliens. That's not a good idea. Vote for the House version. If they adopt the House version, we're fine. And that's one way we can stop this. The second way is if the conferees decide to go ahead with the Senate version, the governor can still veto it. And Governor Baker has always said that he is opposed to allowing illegal aliens to get driver's licenses here. I believe that it could forestall the legislature passing this if the governor threatened to veto it. Just asking to stick with the principles that he's articulated all for many years now and say, legislature, if you pass this budget bill, I'm going to use my line item veto and veto that right out of the budget. I think that would help some of these lawmakers come to their senses. They don't want attention to fall on what they've done. They would rather people not know about it. So we need to let them know that we know, and we need to ask the governor to let them know that he will veto it. So there's two sets of actions. One is to call the six members of the conference committee, and all their names and emails are on the yellow sheet that you have, that I handed out to you when you came in. And also to call the governor and ask him to publicly state that he will veto this provision if it passes. And there are some suggested reasons just to remind you of why giving driver's licenses to illegal aliens is a bad idea. This can be voted. We've stopped this before for several years. When Governor Mitt Romney had it under consideration, he let it know, he knew that he would veto it, and that scared the legislature. So this is very urgent. Issuing driver's licenses to illegal aliens is not only a public safety hazard and it degrades our identity, but it entices more illegal immigration to our state. So I just want to see a show of hands. How many of you are willing to make these phone calls or send emails?
Hey.
That can make a difference. And also, let your friends and neighbors know about this. Ask them to make calls. Even though you may not be in the districts of the conferees, because of their position on the Ways and Means Committee and the fact that they are the six people who are considering this, you don't need to be in their district. We're all their constituents because they're deciding on our budget. Let them know. And keep in mind, there are six of them. The two Republicans are almost certainly going to vote for the House version against the Senate. You just need to convince two of those four Democrats that they need to go with the House version. So this is very, very doable. I know you all have the energy to do it and been successful in the past, so I thank you for your help with this.
Yes? One question. Is there kind of a time frame, like by how soon?
Well,
I'm very busy.
I understand.
They need to finish their work on the budget, which is a huge bill, as you can imagine, and there are many differences between the House and the Senate. They need to finish by June 30th. So, but we don't know when they're in their secret discussions, when they are going to be discussing the Real ID Amendment. So it could happen any time. So the sooner the better. And you know, the sooner they start hearing these calls and getting these emails, the more urgent it becomes for them to do the right thing. Good question. Thank you.
Jessica, neither version will let them vote in any instance at all, ever.
I wish I could promise that.
Well, we need to make sure.
Because we have the federal motor voter law, which allows, if they don't get licenses, they don't get automatically registered to vote.
Right.
So that is a, you know, an important thing. Although, yeah, I mean, that depends a lot on the towns to verify who's coming to vote. Yes, Martha.
Which does a better job of getting the point across, by calling or sending an email?
Call them. But sometimes it's hard to get through, but still leave a message, try to talk to somebody. Emails are okay, some people are more comfortable with that, but calling works better. And if you see them in town or anywhere, you know, talk to them. Corner.
Is snail mail still here?
I don't think we have time for that. I don't know how long it takes to sort the mail at the State House, so you know they might get it next year.
Good. Yes. Already on Facebook.
Thank you. Well,
good.
With this action item, there's six of those. We should be contacting the governor's office. Awesome.
The governor, calling the governor is the second action. The first action is calling the six conferees. Calling the governor is the second.
That's part of it.
Yes, that's a different thing, because what we're asking the governor to do is to publicly state that he will veto this. But we want the legislature to do the right thing. They need to be scared off this nonsense. Mm-hmm. To think that they could do this in secret is outrageous.
Always outrageous.
Yes. Yes.
Just thinking of real quick, as far as coverage, visibility of this, I would say that the Globe and the TNG do a sound purchase from all of that. But has the Herald been clarified on this thing?
I have spoken with a reporter at the Herald who covers the State House, and she knows what's going on. She's been covering this whole issue for a long time now. I haven't seen anything. I personally sent the language in the two amendments to the immigration reporter at the Globe, and they have not covered it either. The only, as I said, the only two places I've seen it have been on the Boston Broadside and the State House News Service. You know, it'd be great for those of you who call into talk radio to start talking about it as well.
Yeah. Jessica, did you call Callie?
I sent it to them.
Okay.
But I have not talked to them about it.
He's been on
this. I did talk about it on Boston Herald Radio. Good.
Good.
All right, thank you all so much.